Red Skull Hydra Doombots. That's it. We're doing it. I already told you. I'm not waiting for Red Skull to become farmable. Y'all might pull him. Y'all might get him in a blitz. Y'all might get him in a random orb. So we're going to talk about this team. Just like some of the other teams, this is a war defense team, Red Skull Hydra specifically, and I'm going to be talking about the most common iteration, not some weird combo that people tend to throw together because they happen to get good red stars on one or the other. So, quick look at the team. What we're going to do, we're going to take a look at them in blitz, which is not really their strong point, but we'll just go into a quick blitz fight as we talk about the availability of this team. So, availability. Red Skull, not available. Cool. The rest of them are available literally everywhere. Most of them have a store access point. Some have a store access point and a node. I believe there's two in the blitz store. Raid store, you can't avoid seeing them. They're also in every premium orb you've ever opened, just as a record. So most of the minions, specifically this team, is comprised of everyone but Grenadier. So you can go ahead and skip Grenadier if you're looking to have this team completed as quickly as possible. The rest of them, they are the 400 credit blitz guys, the cheaper arena guys. They're in everywhere. And Hydra Sniper, I think, has a node in the War Store, which is absolutely great because you have to get him too. But they're pretty accessible. As a matter of fact, most players probably have a 2-star Hydra team right now, if you check, because something happened and you got them. Not really a hard farm. One of the things that happened when Red Skull was introduced into the game is he took these useless characters and gave them a little bit of use. And we'll talk about that right now when we talk about usability. So, usability on this team. Well, they are, as a team, really good at war defense. That's it. Sure, Hydra Scientist has a lot of value outside of the team. Red Skull, great in PvP, works really well with, one campaign node, you could use them. They have a couple of points you can use them in, I believe, Gamma. Early stages of Gamma require Hydra team, or allow Hydra team, I think is or better. And you can use them in some combination to do the first stage of the villains campaign. I wouldn't, but you could. Those are options for them. This is about usability and usefulness. Usability is they can be used there. Usefulness, they're not very useful there. At least this particular iteration of the Hydra team. The Hydra, Red Skull Hydra team. So, they're just not that useful. They're pretty good at war defense until someone has one of the 3 or 4 teams that can beat them. A sufficiently strong enough defenders can punch down against them, which is kind of hilarious because it's not that much of a punch down. But, once you have access to the Hydra offense team or the Symbiotes has a decent chance against them, X-Force can do a pretty decent job. Inhumans can do a pretty decent job. There's plenty of teams to beat them. They were a phenomenal war team, defense team, about 6-7 months ago, but, as time progresses, everything that was good becomes less good, and that's the case. So these are another team that you can just kind of not really pay too much attention to until you need to dump them in war. And again, how strong they are in war is dependent on what you're comfortable investing in characters that are only good in one game mode or how much you care about war specifically. That's it for usability. Now I'd like to talk about tier 4s. I'm going to just make this real quick because there's not many. Starting with Rifle Trooper, for the cause. On revive, 30% piercing to all enemies versus 150. So it's a little bit extra damage. Always assist Hydra allies on non-attack abilities. There's not many non-attack abilities. There's 1, 2, 3 on the team. So if he's the prime damage dealer on the team, so this is a pretty decent tier 4. But, Hail of Bullets. It's basically the same thing that happens when he rezzes. It's just that attack. So... and attack primary target for decent damage plus 5. Anything that just improves piercing, like if it's not actual damage and piercing, that 5% piercing is like 9% regular damage because piercing ignores armor, but armor really doesn't make too much of a difference anyway. Nah. I don't even have him at 65, so I can't even invest in those if I wanted to. And of course, damage. He gets the damage ISO 8 for that. Nothing really crazy there. Hydra Sniper on target. Swipe speed for self. Swipe speed for the Hydra minion and Red Skull. Pretty decent. On war defense. Just going to put this right here. He gains crit chance. Hydra minions and Red Skull gain crit chance. And on spawn, he's stealth, so he can kind of try to stay alive a little bit. 5% speed for the entire team is pretty much the only reason to buy this tier 4. Everything else is cute. Zero in. This is actually awesome. It used to be better. So I know it's funny. When he was a worse character, he used to give offense up to all allies, not just Hydra allies. And they reworked him so he only works with Hydra. Okay. But apply 2 offense up to all Hydra or Red Skull allies, fill speed bar by 10%, plus 10%, so it looks 60. Sure, I guess that's okay, considering that one of the Hydra allies is pretty much never going to attack, and the other one does no damage, and that's a Hydra scientist. You really need this to kind of make sure he does it after Red Skull's summon, so that they all get the offense up, but... not really. Not necessarily awesome. And Marksman Shot. Pretty decent attack. The fact that it's 40% piercing makes it roughly 50. So this is roughly a 300% actual attack. Because it's piercing, it's like a 330 actual attack. So it's not terrible. But you're not using it too often. He doesn't assist. He's okay. Red Skull himself. Hail Hydra. More speed, so you can make this team incredibly fast with him and Sniper, but it is just 5% speed and a little bit of damage. It's a pretty good upgrade, not gonna lie, but the difference of 10 to 15, you can basically get this with, you know, rank 3 ISO 8s on that team, and that's probably a little bit easier to get than wasting these tier 4s on it, so I would argue against it. Storm Assault. Apply offense up to all allies and self. Interesting, right? Because that's exactly what Hydra Sniper does. So it gives them a lot of offense up. Does it matter? Probably not. Attack primary target for 350 goes to 400. Gain assist at 50% damage from 3 to 5 Hydra or guaranteed 5 Hydra allies. This is his summon. It's not often available immediately, but it's pretty reasonable. It could be worse. Or his ultimate, I'm sorry. Elite Guard is his summon. Summon 2 to 3 Hydra minions ready on turn 1. At numbers that don't matter damage. Fill speed bar of self and all allies by 30%. On war defense, generate 2 ability energy for self, which allows him to use his ult immediately on the next turn. But that's only on war defense. With tier 4s, it gets to a guaranteed 3 minions and slightly more damage for the minions. If it filled the speed bar by a little bit, I'd say this is great. I think this is kind of wasted right now. I don't think it's that important. And Hydra Pistol. Attack primary target for decent, but on war defense, apply taunt. 80% chance to chain, but always chain versus 80. You know me, I don't really care about small percentages. It needs to be a guaranteed percentage. You know, more than 3 out of 4 times is good enough than 4 out of 4, but... if you're looking to do something, I guess it's okay. And, as far as ISO 8 on him is concerned, Skirmisher is okay. Crit chance is okay. Damage is okay. Healer is okay. He doesn't have the worst health pool. There's quite a bit of options on it. But the one thing I'll tell you is he doesn't need Fortifier, because if he's taken damage, you've already lost the fight. The biggest thing I will say about Red Skull, though, if you aren't aware, is right here. On war defense, 25% damage reduction per non-summoned Hydra ally. So on his full team that we've been talking about, if they're all there, he takes zero damage. And he's 10,000% resistance against defense down and bleed is what it is. That's what makes him amazing, because he's rezzing the people as they die, and he can't die. So you're constantly fighting the same characters over and over again. You need to make sure you bring in a way to interact with that properly. Moving to Hydra Scientist. Experimental Serum, 10% max health for self, Hydra minions, and Red Skull allies. That's just a flat thing. That's not bad. Going to 20%? That's pretty okay. Apply regeneration plus 2 random effects versus 1 to 2 for the 2 most injured Hydra allies. Unfortunately, it's Hydra allies and not regular allies, but, you know, on the team, it's okay. If that ability was do that for the 2 most injured allies, I would say invest in this, because he's a really useful healer, and you'll see why when you get a test patient 0. Apply death proof and deflect to the most injured ally and heal that ally for 7,000 plus, you know, 15. It goes to 10,000 plus 20% useful heal. On war defense, clear stun from Red Skull ally, which is hilarious. This is just a good heal on its own. Someone's about to die, so give them some health. Make them, you know, take 30% less damage on the next attack, and apply death proof. And it's 2 energy, so it's happening every other turn. Pretty reasonable attack. On the team, it works pretty well, even though they do res themselves. If you've ever fought this team, you know it's... Sometimes he could be a pain. Sometimes I want to kill him first. Not all the time, but sometimes. And then Talon Pistol. Attack, 50% chance to apply heal block. Never increases the chance to apply heal block unless Red Skull is present. And this is just 20% damage and 5% piercing. There's no reason at all to tier 4 this. Last character is Hydra Armored Guard, or the Hag. Hag is awesome for a lot of reasons, starting with Serum. 15% armor and gives armor to everybody. Going up 5% on armor doesn't matter, because armor is kind of a useless stat. On turn, heal for 10% max health. I would not touch this tier 4 with a 10-foot pole. Just armor isn't enough. If he healed himself for 20% and that, I'd say the 20% was worth it. He doesn't, so we're not even talking about it. Alert. Gain taunt for 1 turn. Clear all negative effects from self. Heal 5% per negative effect removed. Heal self for a decent amount of health. And this, by the way, this isn't plus 2,500. This just turns the number to 2,500. It's kind of a problem they have here. Sometimes they say plus, and sometimes they just change the number, and we're not supposed to know which is which unless we read, which probably could be better on their end, but whatever. If Red Skull is an ally, gain immunity. All you need to do is disrupt it. Once you disrupt this, he can't taunt again, and you could just go ahead and kill anyone else you want, or whatever comp is. So, good ability, but nowhere near worth the tier 4. Rapid fire. Apply assist now to Hydra Rifle Trooper ally. Good thing is it will apply it to yours if there are summoned ones. Bad thing, Red Skull can summon a Hydra Rifle Trooper, and if he does, that one sucks. So, it's okay or it's not. Attack primary target for damage. The tier 4 is nothing. So there's absolutely no tier 4s at all worth Hydra Armored Guard. Hydra Armored Guard is just about stats. Put as much as stuff you can get into him as possible. Also, just throwing it out there, when it comes to tier 4s, he doesn't need Fortifier. On this team, none of them need Fortifier because they're all going to be res, so their death doesn't really matter. So you could just go ahead and put damage on him. You can put healer on him. He doesn't have that much health, but it's reasonable. I would put Skirmisher maybe on him, but it's questionable. Most of this team just needs damage. So when it comes to ISO 8s on him, no Fortifiers. You can use healer if you're feeling like things aren't going your way, or you could just do pure damage / Skirmisher if you feel like you're, you know, worried about too many people with hanger up in the beginning of fights, that kind of thing. And that's pretty much it when it comes to the Hydra team. Rating? I don't have a rank under B. The rank under B is trash. The team is trash. I wouldn't do a video on them. So this is a B team, but it's like low B. B minus. B, like, got a 78 on the test B. You know, like, teacher didn't want to give you a C. That's what this team is. They are a good war defense team. They have more counters, and the counter punch up level is way higher. Basically, I'm going to tell you, if the defenders can beat you, not a parody, just if the defenders can beat you, I don't think the defenders can punch down against, like, Asgardians. You know, maybe like 200k, but like, if you have a 300k defenders and a 210k Asgardians, I think the Asgardians might still beat them. Like, it's a hard fight. The defenders will beat this team. Actually, Punisher might just beat this team on his own. There's enough counters to this team now that they're not high impact anymore. They're kind of like the BKT. They're still good on defense, but they're more of a necessity than a bonus. They do fall into the same category of a 90k Hydra team requires roughly the same answer as a 300k Hydra team. The only time I start panicking is if I see a 500k Hydra team, and then I'm like, uh-oh. But honestly, I don't know how many people see 500k teams and don't panic a little bit. So they have their use, but unlike the mercs, you know, they aren't necessary for an event that comes by every month. They don't have a mishmash of characters that can be used to unlock somebody. Red Skull has some value outside of the team in PvP. Hydra Scientist has some value outside of the team as just one of a really good early game healers. Rifle Trooper and Sniper, useless. Hydra Armor Guard, useless outside of the team. Team works well together. But because Red Skull isn't immortal on offense, if he dies, which is very likely, he's not very tanky, and Hydra Armored Guard doesn't tank forever, if he dies, this team just falls apart. They don't have the ability to res, and they're pretty squishy on their own. One of the things about this team that's adorable is how squishy they are because Red Skull reses them, and that makes them more threatening. So, B minus team. Wish I could say that we're better, but they're not. Wish this video could be longer, but it can't. The next video is Hydra Offense, and that's basically just going to be me talking about how good Zemo is and how Zemo is better than the other characters you have to put next to him. And that's only a four-person team, so we'll see how that goes. Anyway, do me a favor, comment below and let me know where you stand. Now, I know Red Skull is one of my favorite characters in Marvel, you know, villainy, but, and I do think they did well enough with his kit. I think just the stuff surrounding him kind of doesn't hold water. And again, remember, this is not an evaluation of Hydra characters. This is evaluation of the Hydra defense team, because this is that Hydra team. These are the characters that work well together for Hydra defense, and more importantly, the characters that work well together that don't have uses in other places. The other Hydra offense team kind of is lined up very well, and you can kind of splash maybe a Hydra scientist on that team, or, you know, Hydra armored guard, and kind of balance it out. But that's another story for another video. For this one, I don't know, Hydra's always been kind of a letdown for me. I haven't really panicked about them. Comment below, let me know how you feel about this team, if you feel like they were worth any investment you put in. Maybe they were for a while. Tell me now if you feel like they're pretty worthwhile. So have a good night, have a great day. I've been Tony Scungili. I'll catch you later.